So I'm in the Orca slicing software now. I choose Orca because it's an offshoot of both the Prusa and the Bambu Labs slicing software, only this one has a bit of an advantage over the other ones, just some additional fine-tune settings, so I like to use it. But the interface is pretty much what you would always see on any of the other ones. If you know how to use the Bambu slicing software, you're going to know how to use this one. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to start off by dropping a piece of the model in, and I'm going to go to stage two because that's a good demonstration of what I'm talking about. So here we go. We're bringing this in. Now I want you to notice, and you'll remember this from the design, that these have a little bit of a lip on them so that they slide over each other, and you can see that right here. Well, that doesn't bode well to have that on the bottom print. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to highlight this object, come over here to my favorite button, lay on face, and I'm going to touch this top face, and boom, now it's over. Now the next thing I want to do is orient it on the build plate a very specific way. This small bracket right here represents the back of your build plate, and this is the front. And if you'll notice, this open seam right here, this is the only one of these that actually opens all the way through the model. Well, I'm going to rotate this so that it actually is at the back. Let's now go through some of the print settings. What I've been using on these is lightweight PLA, as I mentioned before, and I'm using Colorfabb lightweight PLA.
Now, Colorfabb does have a page on their site about how to print with their material on a Bambu Labs printer, so good material there. I will put a link in the descriptions, but I'm going to show you how I do it.
So when I come over here, I have created a user preset called Colorfabb Lightweight PLA. Now, that's just a name until you edit it. And what I'm going to do here is hit this to edit the preset. And in here, there's many ways to do this differently, and this is just a workaround that I thought worked well. It wants to know what type of filament. Well, Colorfabb Lightweight PLA isn't on the list, but what I did choose is ASA, because ASA has similar temperature properties that I would need to print with. Now, here I was able to type in Colorfabb as the vendor, and here's the important thing. In my tests, I have found that about
248 degrees
print temperature and 60% extrusion value works the best for me. So I programmed those into here. I made sure the print temperature, minimum 248 to 260, and then I came down to nozzle and I set both of these at 248. I also set the bed temperatures, and that was pretty much it for the settings that I have for this. Now I'm just going to hit save, and I'm going to save it as the preset name. So here's the deal. When you load your lightweight filament into your printer, you will simply have to tell the printer that it is generic ASA. And when you go to print this, then it will know to select only the ASA filament, which will in fact be your lightweight PLA. So let's look at my settings here. I'm going to go down to the quality setting here. And I have found personally from my own use that 0.24 is a good layer height. It strikes a good balance between speed and strength. So I'm going to come down here to seam, and my seam position is set to back. This is why I rotated this model to have this opening spot towards the back of the build plate. With lightweight PLA, retractions just don't work, and I would rather have all the Z-seam in one space so that creates as little mess as possible, in fact. And also, by the way, lightweight PLA is quite sandable. So if you have a little bit too much of a pronounced bump there, it's always very fixable. Down here under precision, one thing that I will often do is I will mess with XY contour compensation. Now, what that is, if you change these values, it changes where on the G-code center line this filament gets placed. And so if you have parts that don't fit together very well, a little bit too tight, or in this case, what can happen is you could print this and there actually is a physical gap that appears, well, there shouldn't be. So you can dial those settings in by changing these numbers. In my case, 0.1 actually leads to a really clean print. So that's something to take a look at there. I actually, for the rocket at least, I use classic wall generator. No big deal. Works just fine. And we'll go to others tab. And what I'm really going to show here is slicing mode is regular. And I clicked on spiral vase and smooth spiral. So those are the changes that I would want to make to this to be able to print lightweight PLA. Let's look and see how well it slices. I come over here to the slice button, let it run for a second. There we are. We zoom in here. Now what you see is no longer a solid part. It's just a shell. But if I run the simulator of the printhead, you'll now see it. Here it goes, the outside edge. When it completes the outside edge, it's going to go inside and without retracting, start chasing the inside profile. And then it's back to where it starts. Finishes the rest of that ring. And this is how you end up getting these really beautiful clean prints that print quite cleanly all the way down the model. One thing to note here is that I do have bottom layers turned on under strength, and it ends up working out quite well to have a solid edge there. Speeds I have actually adjusted, and I keep the speeds because this is foaming filament. It needs time to heat and foam, so I dial it down to 50 millimeters. That's pretty much all the setting changes that I make on this to get a good clean print of this rocket body. So let's print these parts all up and then move on to assembling. One thing I did forget to mention is that not everything on this rocket is going to be done in lightweight PLA. The axle capsule on the top has some very thin structural framing represented from the original model, and there's just no way you're going to get that done in lightweight PLA. It'll make an absolute mess, and it needs to be stronger. So in this case, I use standard PLA for the capsule and the escape module, and also for the rocket and fin. And one other thing that you will have to do for this is you will have to use supports, because obviously these areas are up in the air. So if you go over here to the support tab, click on this button to enable supports. And what I personally prefer is tree automatic. Reason being is the standard mode will make this area really, really hard to clean. But tree automatic will do its job quite nicely. And so I'm going to go ahead and slice this. And there you have it. These are far easier to remove right there on both this piece and on the rocket, fin, and motor. And bear in mind, you have to make four of these. So now let's move on to building.